He did not forget one young boy. He says, مَا فَعَلَ الْغُلَامِ. So the Sahaba, they said, who were with that delegation in his time, they said, Ya Rasulullah, we never seen a person like him. He is devoted in the A'mal and in the Salat. And if the whole earth has been given to our tribe as a gift, and we are splitting it, he will not turn his face to us. Allah put satisfaction in his heart. Barakah of Rasulullah. So the himma made the brother, himma. And in other side, a Bedouin came to Rasulullah and Rasulullah tell him, ask me. When Rasulullah said his word, ask me, Sahaba, they said, it's rare, very rare that Rasulullah say, ask me. It happened with Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. Abu Huraira also delegation when they come. And as you know, Abu Huraira, which year Abu Huraira came to Medina? You would be surprised, my dear brothers. Abu Huraira came to Medina in the year 8, 2 years before the death of Rasulullah. His name is Abdullah ibn Sakhar. 2 years. So when the delegation of Abu Huraira, they are called Daws, the tribe of Daws, Rasulullah give a talk to the tribe. That's when he meets Abu Huraira. He says, ask me. He says, O Prophet of Allah, teach me from what Allah teaches you. So Rasulullah, with his firasa, with his look, he see that this young boy has so much himma, has a determination to get the knowledge of the deen. He says, sit down. And then he tell him, remove your jubba. And it was a piece of sheet. He was very poor. So then he says, spread it between me and you. So he spread it. Abu says, I spread it between me and Rasulullah, and I see the ant walking through my old sheet that I cover my body with it. And Rasulullah talked to me. When he talked to him, he did not understand what Rasulullah is saying at the first instance. Rasulullah is still talking to him. Then after that, Rasulullah told him, pick these clothes and cover yourself with it. By Allah, anytime you hear me talking, you will never forget. Abu Huraira says, by the one who sent Rasulullah with the truth, I never forget any hadith that Rasulullah said. One time he says, I sit with Abu Huraira, writing the hadith that he reports. He says, I fill the book. Then I come to him after 1 year. And I tell him, oh, Abu Huraira, can you repeat what you repeated to me? And I'm holding the book, and he is far. And by Allah, he repeated letter by letter, vowel by vowel. He did not miss one thing. And ulama, they said, أحفظ الصحابة. The most memorized person in the Sahaba is Abu Huraira. Do you know how many hadith he reported in 2 years? 2 years, how many hadith? 5,374 hadith. So the himma, my dear brother, the himma. May Allah give us, we are saying this because we are weak. A man came to Rasulullah, as I said in the other hand. Rasulullah told him, ask me. Ask me, it means ask me the thing of Akhirah. Dunya will go. He will give you date, he will give you something. You eat, it's finished. But Rasulullah is an opportunity that nobody had. Humanity never had this opportunity. And imagine, he's standing in front of him, telling him, ask me. So then he says, I ask you 2 big camels, fully loaded, with flour and date. So Rasulullah told him, ask me. He says, I don't ask you more than that. So what is his himma? What is his determination? What is his intention? Material, food, that's all. As scholars, they said, some people, determination are digging on the house of birds, and some people are their himma is the throne of Allah. So Rasulullah, he tells Sahaba, fill his camel, give him 2 camels, fill it with date and flour. By Allah, the old lady of Banu Israel is wiser than him. And Sahaba, they like knowledge. When Rasulullah mentioned this, they want to know who is the old lady of Banu Israel. So when he proceeds, he says to them, when Musa took Banu Israel and they crossed the Red Sea, and Allah destroyed their enemy, when they were in the point to leave Egypt, Allah make the day for them dark. Allah send darkness on them. So Banu Israel, he tell them, sit. This is a sign of an anger of Allah. What promise we did not fulfill to Allah? So Banu Israel, they said, we heard as a will from our ancestor that Yusuf, when he was in the deathbed, he said to Banu Israel, if I die, take my body to my fathers, bury me beside my fathers. And we left him behind. He says, this is the reason why Allah turned the sky into darkness. Then he says, who knows where Yusuf is buried, alayhi salatu wasalam. So they said, it's an old woman that is the only one that knows the place. Musa come to her. He tell them, show me the lady. When he come to that old woman, he says, oh woman, show us the place of where Yusuf is buried, so we can take him with us. So she said, I won't show you the place till you fulfill my question. He says, what is your need? She said, I want to be with your place in Jannah. Rasulullah say about the man who asked flower and date. And Rasulullah is telling him, ask me. And he took the camels and he is too happy. And this woman, what she said to Musa, I want to be, if you want me to show you the spot, spot is easy. Just place to show. But she says, I want to be with you in Jannah. So Musa, he says, those are the position of Anbiya, cannot be given to normal people. As if he hesitate. Allah revealed to him, it is not your Jannah. Grant her question. Allah akramul akrameen. So Musa said, oh Allah, give to this ajuz position with me in Jannah. Then she showed him the place. It was like a berka. Berka is a small lake that water is stable. And he asked them to remove the water. Then she showed them support and they took Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. So this is the himma. Baqi ibn Mukhallal. Remember this name. Baqi ibn Mukhallal. A very young student from Andalusia. Andalusia means Spain. That time was Islam start in Spain. He traveled from, in the time of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, he traveled from Andalusia, walking till he reached Baghdad in Iraq, where Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal is captured to seek the knowledge. Can you imagine? Only to learn the knowledge. And he had some money that he saved, and he sat in a small motel. Motel that time it was a house for a poor man that let him in and he takes some money. So, because 3 days was free, but if you tell him I'm staying for 1 year, 2 years, that's called, he has to pay. So he stayed in the motel and he says, I went through Baghdad asking for Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. So they told him it's on Mihna. Mihna, it means when the Imam Ma'mun forced him to say, Quran is a created. Quran is a created. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal refused to say that. And that's why ulama, they said, if Abu Bakr Siddiq did not stand on the people of Ridda, people will worship idol on Jazeera. And if Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal did not stand on this mihna, people will say Quran is creation of Allah. And that's why they call him Imam Ahl Sunnah. So when he says, when he comes to Imam Ahmad, knock his door, he says, I come to seek knowledge and I come walking from Andalusia. Can you teach me? He says, son, how can I teach you? And you see that I'm under siege and I cannot do any halaq al-masjid and I'm praying inside the house. I'm not allowed to leave them at the house. So listen, my dear brother, the himma of this young boy, what he told him. Look, the idea. He says, oh, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, I will wear old clothes. And I will say, Al-Ajr Rahimakumullah. Al-Ajr Rahimakumullah means reward, may Allah mercy on you. And the beggars that time, they used to say this word. Reward, may Allah mercy on you. It means you will get reward if you give me. May Allah mercy on you. So he says, I will wear old clothes, and I will keep knocking the doors, and I will say, reward, may Allah rahmah on you. And I will fold under my armpit a book and pen. So I will just stand on your, knocking your door. And from the window, you don't open, I will keep knocking. From the window, you tell me one hadith, I write it down, and I will keep coming every day. Look, my dear brothers, seeking the knowledge. Look the books standing on shelves. Spider web in it. How much these hadiths have been compiled? Imam ibn Hanbal urinate blood, seeking the hadith. Imam Sufyan Tawri urinate blood, seeking the hadith. Ulama said Imam Hanbal urinated blood by thirst. Imam Sufyan Tawri urinated blood by cold, looking for hadith. Jabir ibn Abdullah traveled from Medina to the Sham, 1 month journey. And he listened to one hadith and he came back. So Imam Ahmad Baqiy ibn Khalad, he stayed 1 year collecting the hadith. He says when the mihna released and he started giving the halaqa, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, when he see Baqiy ibn Khalad, he used to stand up from the minbar and call him close to him. And he says, this is the students of ilm. And he told them the story. So one day, he says, I will resume it. He says, one day I got sick and I was in my small hotel, in my lying. I could not move because I was too sick. Imam Ahmad al-Hanbal heard that I am sick and he come visit me. He says when he was coming, I hear the crowd in the street because it was poor street. And everybody say, Imam Ahmad al-Hanbal is here. He says when he come to my place, sit beside my bed and make dua for me and left, the owner of that says, by Allah, will you never pay. You have such connection with Allah that Imam Ahmad Muhammad visit you, you will be staying free. And this is the barakah of the ilm. Allah give us tawfiq. So my dear brothers, ulama, they said one of the worst things that kill our himma, kill our determination to please Allah, is the dunya. Let's be frank. The dunya kill it. The thirst of dunya kill this himma. Destroy it. Like you pour vinegar in the honey. And you are not going to eat more than what Allah did for you. We don't say you give up dunya. No, my dear brothers. Abdul Rahman Mu'af used to have caravan. Caravan like you say now, two or three trucks that go to Mexico for the import food. And when he died, they have to break the gold with axe to share between his inheritance. But their thirst, their love, their concern, their emotion was only Allah. And this is, my dear brother, the difference. Sahaba, they had this zeal to please Allah. And look, when you, I finish by this, if you look to the questions of Sahaba, if you look the book of Hadith, check the questions of Sahaba. What Sahaba ask? One Sahabi says, O Prophet of Allah, man aqrabu minka majlisan. Who is the closest person to you? Look at the question. It means when someone asks, something bothers him. He has concern. He wants to be close to Rasulullah. He says, Ya Rasulullah, man aqrabu nasi minka majlisan. O Prophet of Allah, who is so close to you in your position in Jannah? Another Sahabi says, Ya Rasulullah, man afdal al-a'mal. Ma hiya afdal al-a'mal? What is the highest good deeds? They don't say like that, question in the air. No, they ask to do, to get, to deserve that answer. Another Sahabi says, O Prophet of Allah, what is the heaviest thing in the balance in the Day of Judgment? What is this question? What does it mean, my dear brothers? It means their himma, their concern, their worry to please Allah. Another Sahabi says, O Prophet of Allah, ma yudhiku Allah yawm al-qiyamah. What make Allah laugh in the Day of Judgment? So this is, my dear brother, called the ulama, they call it the himma. And that's why scholars, they said, we have to inculcate it. How? Make intention. Make programs. It's easy. Just make program. Include your program in the dunya. As one scholar say, and this is a beautiful example. Sheikh Elias from Dawah, he said this example. Beautiful. I love this example because it explains our hal, our situation. He says, the dunya now is like train that has no spot. All the seats are full. So when you ask anyone, everyone has his own train. My train has a place of the wife, place of the job, place of kids, place of... even sport and everything, but there is no space for the deen. There is no time, like 1 hour to follow halaqa, 1 hour to visit the Muslim, 1 hour to reserve it for visiting hospitals, brothers. Do you know how many sick in the hospital? They have no family, no kids, no one wife. I remember in Montreal, I visit one person, no one visit him. 16 years he's in the bed. He died by accident. So, he says, squeeze the program of the deen in the dunya. So your dunya will have value. It's like a check, too many zeros. If I give you a check with too many zeros, it has no value. You are having dunya, but actually it's no value because once you die, you are going to live naked. It's like zeros in the check. But if you squeeze, if you put one, digit one, ahead of these zeros, it will have value. And this is the deen. Life, Yaakov. As-salamu alaykum.